Hi, I'm Peter. I'm an engineer from Germany, and this is my NAS. I built this NAS in the year before going to university as a pure hobbyist project. In 2008, network-attached storage devices were just becoming a thing, and the few that were available were quite expensive. Socket 7 was already an old platform even back then, but I had this free system which I used to start experimenting with Linux. I hosted dedicated game servers for private LAN parties on it and tried out other shenanigans. When the Half-Life dedicated server binary for Linux dropped i586 support and this system became obsolete for its former usage, I came up with a new use for it. I was pretty big into case modding at the time and dreamed about building a high-class case con, but maybe something with a purpose. So I started designing, constructing and building a slick and compact case around the Socket 7 Baby AT motherboard to use it as a cheap NAS. The finished case actually got admitted to the German Case Mod Championship 2008 and the Gamescom Case Mod Masters later that year. And although I didn't make it to the podium, the case was received very well and I was really proud of it. Over the past 15 years, the hardware of my NAS hasn't changed much. In the DFI K6 BB3 Plus motherboard with 1 MB of onboard cache sits a 500 MHz AMD K6 3 Plus and a single stick of 256 MB SD RAM. A compact flash to IDE adapter hosts a 4 GB SwissBit compact flash for the OS. The PCI SATA adapter is a Davi Control DC150. The network interface card, a 3COM 10100 fast, well, not by today's standard, Ethernet adapter and the USB 2.0 ports are added with a VIA USB FireWire combo card. My NAS currently can accommodate two 2.5-inch hard drives and is powered by a 90-watt Pico PSU. In the front, it has a 240x64 pixel monochrome LCD from Sharp, which is connected to the parallel port to display status information. I've since then used the NAS for occasional backups and to store non-critical data, though especially the really not fast 100 megabit Ethernet made it more and more a pain to use. But let's see what it's currently capable of. The operating system it's running is Debian Jesse, which is the last version of Debian with i586 support. I even went through the effort of compiling the backported kernel version 4.9 from source directly on the NAS itself, as Debian ships it as 686 binary only. Transferring a file from the NAS, we reach about 10 MB per second, which is okay for a 100 megabit network card, but only barely usable these days. When trying to write to the NAS, it becomes apparent that something is wrong with its network connection, as we are only getting transfer speeds of less than 1 MB per second. So this problem occurred some time ago and I haven't been able to find the reason for it so far, but fixing the 100 megabit connection wasn't really going to do it for me anyway. If I want to keep this NAS running for daily use, some major improvements in throughput and data integrity are necessary. Unfortunately, just swapping the NIC to a gigabit card isn't really an option, as the case is specifically tailored to the 3COM card, so a major upgrade with changes to the case seems inevitable if I want to keep this NAS alive. I really wonder why I chose this NIC in the first place. It's not like gigabit wasn't a thing in 2008, but I was a poor student and didn't see me upgrading our home network to gigabit in the near term back then. As I'm still proud of the work achieved with this case, I really don't want it to sit in a corner and collect dust, and I see two upgrade paths to make it a 24/7 usable NAS again. Either keep only the case and make it accommodate some slightly more modern mini or nano ATX based system, or stay with the Socket 7 Baby AT and tune the hell out of it and see how far it can go. As with my cars, I love to keep old platforms alive and spice them up with some modern parts here and there. So avoiding any rational considerations, my choice was pretty obvious. And when I realized that I can run pretty much any server grade 64-bit PCI or PCIX cards in the 32-bit slots, there was no return and parts started to pile up. Among all the networking cards I acquired for testing, there was one that actually had the RJ45 jack in the exact same position as the old 100 megabit card. So upgrading to the specific card was actually straightforward. With the 3COM3C996T, which kind of sounds like a Porsche model name, and that must be a good sign, right? So with this card and the appropriate firmware binary installed, I already got a significant performance gain. And another easy upgrade was to change the SIL3512 based DAVI Control DC150 SATA controller for a SIL3124 based card, which gave another small improvement. So let's see what the performance is now with these upgrades in place. Transferring a 1GB test file to the NAS, I now get around 15 megabytes per second, which isn't quite gigabit line speed, but definitely much more usable than the obviously broken transmission from before. And reading back the file from the NAS results in a solid 28 megabytes per second. Also not a whole lot, but almost 3 times as fast as before. So here's a recap of all these numbers. Before the upgrade, it was barely possible to write any new data to my NAS with write speeds below 1 megabyte per second. Read speeds were about what to expect from a 100 megabit connection, but not the kind of performance you'd want from a NAS, even back in 2008. With the new NIC and SATA controller installed, my NAS is now capable of hitting 15 megabyte per second write and 28 megabyte per second read speeds, which is just 2 megabyte per second short of the $600 QNAP TS409 Pro from 2008. Considering that the SuperSocket 7 platform was already 10 years old by the time the QNAP came out, these numbers are nothing to be ashamed of. Of course I could be happy with the throughput after this easy upgrade and just call it a day. After all, I'm getting the same level of performance as a premium NAS from 2008 for a fraction of the cost. That's without considering the price for all the parts I had to buy to find this combination. But it ain't 2008 anymore, and now that I have all this server grade hardware, I obviously also want to know how it performs on the SuperSocket 7 platform. And after some first tests on my bench setup, I can already tell that there's a lot of performance left on the table. So make sure to subscribe and let me know in the comments if you want to see the Socket 7 NAS aiming for the stars and witness the unorthodox solutions I'll have to come up with to reach for them.